The old order changeth, yielding place to new, my journey. It wasn't a mere stroll through Sunset Boulevard. Across centuries, I was chugging faithfully through a trail of hope, bridging cultures, building relationships. It all began in the early stages of the 20th century, when India was still a dominion of the British Crown. The South Indian Railway Company had an ambitious plan to link all peninsular India, and Palghat-Pollachi was just a tiny blimp on the transportation map of the colony. It was the winter of October 1928 when I first heard about it. Sri K. Kunyakrishnan Nair, the deputy collector, had started to acquire land to lay the track between Palghat and Pollachi. Those were the days of challenges galore, of land acquisitions, of fixing the alignment, of finalizing the ruling gradient, and of linking the track from both ends. There was a pleasant sense of anticipation. The young heart of mine skipped a beat. I was going to run. After what seemed an eternity, nearly 4 years, finally the good news came. Messrs. Ramji Lira and Company of Kukma, who belonged to the Kutch Gurjar Kshatriya community, had successfully completed the construction of my track. Their contribution to my cause, my journeys, have been immense.
India Railways consisted of three different gauges: broad gauge, meter gauge, and narrow gauge. Broad gauge had a kilometer of around 33,000 plus. Meter gauge was also 24,000 plus, and narrow gauge was 3,000-4,000 kilometers. It was the meter gauge and narrow gauge. As such, these difference in gauges in most of the countries in the world, there is a unique same gauge running throughout the country. India was the only country where different gauges were operating in the railways. The section from Pollachi to Palghat was among the these type of sections. The work was started quite a few years back. Due to financial constraints, it took some time to complete it, but it has been successfully completed, and Commissioner of Railway Safety has inspected and given his certification for running the broad gauge trains in this section. And shortly the passenger goods train services have already started, and passenger train services also will be started shortly. This line from Pollachi to Palghat, it connects, it was completing a section. So the Tamil Nadu and Kerala will be again seamlessly connected by this broad gauge route, and it will benefit the travelling public of both these areas, especially the religious shrine at Palni, and other persons who are served by the catchment area will be benefited.
Like Johnny come lately, the new kid in town, people were talking about me, talking of the 34 miles I was going to cover, talking about the new meter gauge track and how this was going to save them about 25 miles if they wished to go to Palani, Madurai or Rameshwaram. that popular pilgrimage route. All of this was making me feel things, feelings that were new to me, things I had never experienced before, emotions of joy, of fear, of excitement. The adrenaline rush, the race against time, in my attempts at conquering space. The journeys used to start from here. The town station, located in the heart of the city, Palakkad, the granary of Kerala. Tracing back the etymology of Palakkad makes you choose the fusion of Pala and Kada, meaning barren and forest, to the more popular one of the land of Pala trees. My new route, an alternate. After running around 15 kilometers in the hot sun, Pudunagaram was the first place I would break. Me lazing, trees shading, while people would load me with sacks of mangoes, bound for the northern parts of our country. Formerly called Pallashana Road Station, Vadakanyikapuram derived its name from the local goddess, Vadakanyika.
Palakkad section is a part of Dindigul, Palani, Polachi, Palakkad and Polachi Coimbatore project. Polachi Palakkad section is about 54 kilometers. Since the total stretch covered by this project is about 220 kilometers, so we had to tackle this project in stages. This particular project is a very important project from connectivity point of view, because it is going to connect both the important stations of Kerala as well as Tamil Nadu. So we started carrying out the work in stages, and we have completed the work section wise. First we have completed the section between Dindigul to Palani, that is about 57 kilometers, followed by section between Palani to Pallachi, that is about 63 kilometers. Then our priority was to take up the work of Pallachi to Palakkad section, so that this connectivity from North Kerala to South Tamil Nadu could be established and train services could be routed through this particular section. The Pallachi Coimbatore section, there was some problem of land acquisition which has delayed our work, but now the land acquisition has been completed and that project is also slated for completion during the next financial year, and we will be commissioning that project now.
The next stop was the picturesque station of Mudalamada. Being one of the biggest mango-producing villages in the country, its fruit varieties loved beyond frontiers. The mangoes that I transport from here often end up in the markets of Europe, a gourmet's delight in the dining halls of the continent. Banyan trees flanking the platforms. Leaving Mudalamada behind, I move on, blurring the borders of states and culture. I reach Meenakshipuram and Meenachipuram. Same, yet different. The amalgam is evident. The mixing, beautiful. The last halt before my destination is a small station called the Annamalai Road, named after the famous Annamalai Hills of the Western Ghats. The Aliyar Dam with Valpare looming large at the back, as I pass, is a sight to behold.
Total length is 55 km, out of which we are having about 153 minor bridges and 7 numbers of major bridges. There are total of about 48 level crossing gates before gauge conversion, and we have made it as 26 level crossings only. About 19 level crossings are closed by providing limited use subway, road or bridges, or it is permanently closed with the cooperation of the state government. So now there is only 26 level crossing gates, out of which 8 are unmanned and the balance 18 are manned. This project, that is this 55 km between Pollachi and Palakkad, it is a part of gauge conversion between Dundikkal Pollachi and Pollachi Palakkad and Pollachi Coimbatore. The total estimated cost was 350 crores, but now the lowest estimate says it will be around 900 crores. And for Pollachi Palakkad alone, we have spent about 225 crores so far. And there are two major stations, Pollachi and Palakkad Junction. And other crossing stations are about 4 crossing stations. All the 4 crossing stations are provided with 2 loop lines with 1 main line. All of them are having 2 platforms. All will accommodate 18 coach lines, except this Pollachi and Palakkad are having 24 coach line platforms. We have provided all the facilities like tutor bridges, platform centers, water supply arrangements, and other passenger arrangements like seating arrangements, water supply arrangements, everything we have provided in a good manner, which will be used, it will be very, very useful for the passengers using the stations.
Nearing Pollachi was always the saddest part, knowing that all of this would end soon. In ancient times, they called it Purul Achi, the land of the wealthy. Being a commercial and trading hub, it's one of the most relevant towns of Coimbatore. The coconuts, the blooming coir trade, the agricultural products, jaggery, vegetables, the cattle markets, the temples. To make films, people come from all corners here, for unlikeliest of reasons.
We are going to go to the local train.
எங்களுக்கு எல்லா சரக்குகளும் கரெக்டாக விற்றுடும், அப்போ நஷ்டங்கள் வராது.
Bearing witness to all of this for a century stands the Pollachi station. I could ask the wooden crane to testify. It has an industrial heritage of its own, a charm of the last vestige of a colonial past. Reaching here always gave me a sense of accomplishment. They add life to my years, give meaning to my life, my purpose. I was proud. In the larger scheme of things, I was the link. I had interlinked Dindigul, Podanur, Pollachi and Palakkad. I had connected Udupi to Palani, Mumbai and Tuticorin, Dwaraka and Rameshwaram. I have connected the dots, yet I held it all together. I am proud.
The Pollachi Palakkad line was constructed in 1932 as a meter gauge line for providing a connectivity to the southern Tamil Nadu from the Malabar area. This line served for journey up to Rameshwaram also. But as a policy of the Government of India for Unigauge, the work was sanctioned for conversion with the broad gauge. And work started in December 2008 when the section was closed for conversion. This section after conversion will be advantage to the public as it will provide a direct connectivity from the southern Tamil Nadu state to Malabar area and to the Konkan area. And in turn, it will provide a shorter route up to Mumbai, Gujarat, that is Dwarka and Haridwar of the Northern Railway. Thus, pilgrims can directly take a train from the main center of the pilgrimage, Haridwar, Rishikesh, or to from Dwarka and coming to the Rameshwaram. This will also provide a shorter route to the Madurai from Palakkad by curtailing almost 106 kilometers. It will also provide an alternate route for the goods moving from the E-road to Cochin or going towards Bangalore port, and thus facilitate easier operation, provide alternate route, and will be of immense use for the local passenger, local population of the hitherto deprived area of the Pollachi and Palani and portion of the Kerala.
That was it. Out to the blue, I ceased to exist. Now, when I look back, every journey that I made, all those memories, the 76 years, everything flashes by my eyes. One great journey. It makes me think about life, the insignificance of it, how little a lifetime feels like, but how, in the end, we all crave for more, how it's never enough, the liveliness of life. I have been waiting for this one moment, hoping when monsoons dampened my spirit, hoping when 6 years seemed infinite, hoping that life would happen, a resurgence, a rejuvenation.